array formulas. We've looked at how to analyze the data for the quality of the exam. So we're not necessarily looking at the quality of students, we're looking at what questions in our exam contribute towards the end marks. And I think we can say that we've come to the conclusion that that question two doesn't really help. It's not different from question one. So of course we can just clear the content, throw everything away. But that's not what I want. I manually inputted everything, so I want to keep the values, but still I want to have the ability to analyze. So I could filter, but the way the filtering works in Excel is you can only filter in this direction. You can only filter on rows, and you can't filter on columns. And that's exactly what I want, because I want to filter out one question, and I don't want to filter out one student. So what I need to do is change my data, transpose my data into being in a different direction. So how to do that? What I can do is I made another worksheet called Exam Transpose, where I want to transpose my data. And Excel has a function for that. I can just say transpose, type it in the formula bar. There we go, transpose. And then I select the array of data that I want to transpose. And then I hit Control Shift Enter. So what I get now is just one cell, because as we've seen in the previous video, I haven't given Excel the room, the space, to plot the entire array. So if I want to have everything transposed, I need to make sure that there's enough room in my worksheet to plot everything. So how much room do we need? Well, we have 16 rows, so that will be 16 columns. And we have 14 columns currently, so that will be 14 rows. So if we go back to our transposed worksheet, we make sure that we make enough room for everything, and then we can use the transpose function with Control Shift Enter, making it into array formula, and then we get the result of the entire array. So what was previously one row is now in the transposed version one column. So why am I showing you this? Well, first of all, we want to have the results in a different direction, but I also want to point out an important difference in Excel functions. Some functions are array functions. For instance, transpose, if you enter it, you already see as an argument, you need to put in an array. So the transpose is an array function in a sense. It always operates on an array. There's no other way. You can't put in a number. It doesn't know how to transpose a number. However, other functions, like the subtract function that we've seen in a previous video, they not are inherently array formulas, but you can make them into array formulas by giving them a range as an argument, and then they can be made to work on all the pairs. So some functions are array, others can be made array, and that's also what the exercises of this video will be about.